Hi everybody, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So in today's vlog, I'm going to discuss about how you can become a lawyer in Ontario, what is the process, choti choti details hoti hain about which not many people are aware, and how can you read about it, aapko research kahan se karni hai, what all the material that you have to look into. Also because, you know, I get so many queries in bits and pieces and I wanted to gather this whole vlog and discuss about Ontario as a province ki as a lawyer, what is the process of converting and licensing yourself here, what is the federal exam, the NCAs as you know, and I've already made a vlog on the NCA exams, you can go check out and the link is in the description box. Today I'm specifically going to talk about the small rules and regulations that are with Law Society of Ontario and what is the job scope, how's the job market, and what I personally have felt in this province. So let's go check out, and I am so sorry that I'm making this vlog after such a long time, because as you know, I obviously we moved into a new space with Ace Law. Ace Law, thank you for all your blessings for Ace Law. Ace Law is completely doing great, and we moved into a new house. As you can see, the curtains are also not opened as of now, so I'm just in the process of all of that, but I still wanted to complete this vlog series, and today Ontario is the destination we are going to discuss. हाँ जी, तो सबसे पहले बात करते हैं अबाउट ऑन्टारियो एज अ प्रोविंस. ऑन्टारियो इज लोकेटेड हियर एंड एज यू कैन सी द पॉपुलेशन ऑफ ऑन्टारियो इज कंपैरेटिवली वेरी हाई व्हेन इट कम्स टू कंपेयरिंग इट टू अदर प्रोविंसेस ऑफ कनाडा. ऑन्टारियो एज अ पॉपुलेशन इज हाई बिकॉज ऑल द इमिग्रेंट्स प्रेफर कि यहाँ तो ऑन्टारियो आए या बी सी सेटल हुए, बी सी बिकॉज ऑफ द वेदर एंड ऑन्टारियो बिकॉज इट इज द फाइनेंशियल कैपिटल ऑफ कैनेडा, इनफैक्ट नॉर्थ अमेरिका. इट्स गॉट मैनी अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर पीपल ऑफ डिफरेंट बैकग्राउंड एंड सिंस जहाँ पे लोग होते हैं वहाँ पे अपॉर्चुनिटीज अपने आप क्रिएट होती हैं. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द रीजंस दैट ऑन्टारियो इज वन ऑफ द चोजन डेस्टिनेशन, एंड दैट्स व्हाई द लॉ सोसाइटी हैज मेनी काइंड ऑफ प्रोग्राम्स एंड मेनी वेज थ्रू विच यू कैन इमिग्रेट विदाउट हैविंग द डिफिकल्टी ऑफ गो. जैसे अदर प्रोविंसेस में, आपका कई प्रोविंसेस में, जैसे हमने अल्बर्टा में डिस्कस किया था कि आपको 10 मंथ्स की वो आर्टिकलिंग कंपलसरी करनी होती है, यहाँ पे भी करनी होती है, बट आई विल टेल यू हाउ यू कैन वेव दैट ऑफ, व्हाट आर द एग्जेम्पशंस एंड हाउ यू कैन अप्लाई फॉर दैट. सो ऑल इन ऑल व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू सी इज व्हाई ऑन्टारियो इज मोस्ट प्रेफर्ड. एज आई टोल्ड यू, इट्स बिकॉज ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल कैपिटल एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द अपॉर्चुनिटी दिस मार्केट कैन ऑफर यू. Secondly, now we are going to discuss about the process of how you can become a lawyer in Ontario. So if you have done your law from any of the common law countries and you have studied the common law, not the civil law, if you've studied the common law, then you are probably first giving the NCA exams. Not probably, of course you are giving the NCA exams. NCA is the federal exam. NCA federal exams होते हैं. So मुझे बड़ी सारी queries आती हैं जिसमें ये लोग पूछते हैं कि NCA के लिए IELTS चाहिए होते हैं. नहीं, NCA की website पर जाओ, NCA की सारी details आपको वहाँ पर मिल जाएंगी. मैं link भी share कर रही हूँ description box में. NCA के बाद जो step 2 होता है, once you have cleared your NCA and you've got your certificate of qualification, even when you have not got your certificate of qualification, certificate of qualification NCA के आने में 3 months लग जाते हैं. So in between also what you can do is you can get licensing as a, you can get registered as a licensee candidate with that particular law society where you want to go. Now for example, I had to come to Ontario, so I got myself registered with the Law Society of Ontario after giving my NCA exams and after getting the result of passing and all. So once that is done, you get registered. Inki registration I think around $175 ki hoti hai, and if you're late it's probably 75 more. So you don't have to be late for that particular year, you try and be within that cycle, because Law Society of Ontario ki aapki cycle hoti hai, 3 years ke liye aap usme registered rehte ho, uske baad aapko renew karani padti hai. सो आप लाइसेंस और आपको लाइसेंसिंग प्रोसेस कोशिश करनी चाहिए उस 3 ईयर्स में आप कंप्लीट कर लो. सो फर्स्ट आपने LSO की वेबसाइट पे जाना है, जो मैंने लिंक डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में दिया है, आफ्टर क्लियरिंग योर FLSC NCA एग्जाम्स. उसके बाद आपने क्लिक करना है ऑन बिकमिंग अ मेंबर. देन यू हैव टू सी हाउ इंटरनेशनली ट्रेन्ड लॉयर्स के लिए उनके पास क्या क्या, उनको कैसे लॉयर बनना है, तो उन्होंने लॉ सोसाइटी की वेबसाइट पर दिया हुआ है. सो वंस यू हैव डन दैट, क्लिक ऑन becoming a member, see the process. Now, the process says that you have to do 10 months of articling, you have to give the barrister, and you have to give the solicitor exam. So once you click on the link that I have shared in the description box, what you will reach is the lawyer licensing process for Law Society of Ontario. Ab sabse pehle jab aapne register kar liya, then you are going to go through the application. Now, there are two parts of this application. Part one has to be submitted online by you, and part two, all the documents, requisite documents, have to be mailed by you. Once you have submitted all your documents and your registration with them is complete, you become a member and you get a licensing candidate number. In fact, you even get your ID as a licensing candidate. You have to do the mandatory components of that licensing process. First is you have to give the barrister. So this can be in any order. Not necessarily you have to give first as barrister, solicitor, and do the training, but it can be in any order. You can do the training first and you can give the bar exams later, or vice versa. So the mandatory components in gist are, first you have to give the barrister exam. The barrister material will be given to you by the Law Society. It cost the whole exam plus the material cost around 900 Canadian dollars, I believe. So all of that, and then it's an open book exam. It used to be a 7-hour open book exam when I gave, but now I've heard due to COVID they have taken the whole platform online, and it's now being conducted for usually around 4 hours. And I think it's going to go like that till March 2021. I'm not sure of the whole of 2021. So the barrister, the solicitor, these are open book exams, but let me tell you guys, these are like the grandeur version of NCS. NCS compared to bar exams are not at all difficult, and bar exams are difficult. They require extensive study, extensive hold on material, on the procedural part, and on solicitor differently and on barrister differently. The approach is different. In fact, we can make one dedicated vlog on bar exams and how I prepared, how I studied, and how I cleared the bar exams. Thereafter, you have to also simultaneously, maybe I would not suggest simultaneously, but maybe after your bar exams or before your bar exams, go under a training. Either you can go for an articling, which is, by the way, very difficult to get under some lawyer, because yahan pe articling is usually booked around 2, 3, 1 or 2. Log to 2-2 saal pehle, I've heard they book their articling in under some prestigious institutions here. But once you, and you need to have a valid status, of course. Let me tell you that you can't do that on a visitor. You have to have a work permit, or you have to be a permanent resident in Canada to complete your articling. Secondly, what you can do is you can take the law practice program. So alternatively, besides articling, the Ryerson University in collaboration with Law Society of Ontario offer the LPP, which is the law practice program, which is conducted in English. It's a 8-month program, which used to be 4 months used to be in training, and 4 months used to be your work component. Now I do not know about, because of COVID, they might have taken the whole thing online. I'm not sure. But anyway, they take 4 months of training, in which 4 weeks you have to come in person. 4 times in 4 months you have to come in person, and they will take assignments, they will give assignments. They'll probably train you like an entry level lawyer, and what you have to take in order to practice in the province of Ontario. So the law practice program helps you get that hands-on experience in which you might lack, because articling positions are limited and students are more. So that's a good option you can consider. Now, people who have experience in legal field, especially in kind of courts and litigation and all of that, and have 10 months of experience, they can apply for exemption. The exemption procedure is also given on Law Society of Ontario's website, LSO's website. You can go check that out also if you want to, if you are trying to seek exemptions. There are certain things that they require, and you can go fill in that and fulfill those details. Now, people who must have in-house experience or have other related legal experience in the past can go for abridgment. Abridgment mein maybe 10 months ko wo 5 months kar dein ya 6 months kar, they are going to shorten the gap or the articling period, and that's going to be very helpful. If you can now do any of, but you have to do something. Either you have to do articling, or you have to do LPP, or you can seek exemption. Once you seek exemption, you're also going to pay an amount of around 1,000 for attending one training, PCPO training, in which there it's a 4 or 5 day training in which they will give you material and there will be assignments with groups, and you have to go and go to the law society. Right now it must be online, but otherwise usually it's in the LSO's hall. So once all that is over and you have cleared your bar exams, congratulations, you are going to get an invite to the call to the bar ceremony. And for the call to the bar ceremony, it's going to make you feel very prestigious and very important, privileged here in Ontario. They are going to give you your degree and your certificate, and it's like a proper jury which will sit, and it's a moment to celebrate. So when all of that is done, you become licensed to practice law in Ontario. So now that you have become a lawyer, the important thing is the job market. We are going to look into some data for doing that. But right now, let me tell you, due to COVID, 40%, it's in the job, in the legal field, that 40% have been cut off. Jobs have been cut off, either in-house or working with law firms, but then it has been very badly hit. So let me discuss some of the pre-COVID reports that I have with me, and you're going to look at it now. The employment outlook will be fair for lawyers in Quebec notaries in Ontario for the period of 2019 to 2021. The following factors contributed to this outlook. Employment growth will lead to several new positions. Several positions will become available due to retirement. There are small number of unemployed workers with recent experience in this occupation. So usually what you are going to look at is that the unemployment rate is not that high, but I have known people who have been unemployed even after clearing those exams, and job market is actually very hard hit right now. So this is not even a good time to judge the job market, but in due course also it really depends on your internal references, where you're getting placed and how are you performing and how is your articling and the whole experience of law. See, this is not a one time of application job that you're going to get. This is a whole process. You have to integrate with the process, and only then can you be successful in this field. So all these are very small tips, but I hope you these are useful for you guys. And if there's any other thing that you want to know about Ontario, you can put in the comment section. I'm going to try and reply to each one of them. It gets very difficult for me to reply on other platforms, so I request that you can put here on YouTube and I will try and answer all of that and related to this vlog. So bye guys, good night, take care, and I'll be back soon with a very interesting vlog. I am sure you guys will love it, and just wait for it, and take care, bye bye.